times for every half hour of study. Your teacher or coach may allow you to study in more than one course. For example, if you finish the first half of First English, you can also study English for Success.
I wouldn't stick with you, right? I'm hoping. But I'm just pointing it out. We use it a lot. You can see how important it is, even for yourselves. As adults, very smart, very, you know, professionals, still reviewing and repetition is helpful to understand. You understand that you don't, your students don't learn things by doing things just once. Or for you, explaining things to them just once. Half of you, those of you who haven't deleted your classes and transferred yourself into the main class, should do that first. Then take the confirmation master test if you haven't taken that. Then follow the tasks that ask you to start studying new dynamic English. Let's look at exactly what the records manager tells us when we look inside in detail. You're going to log on exactly as you have been. Next is the group name, the password, next admin 1. But in actual fact, it's not going to be an admin password, even though it says admin 1. We're changing it. So you don't have the right to make other changes we don't want you to have. Students' records. Let's see, this person has been in 45 minutes, so are you here, Trophy?
No.
Okay, now we know who you are. And we know what. And if you look at if you change this to all courses, you would see a mix of whatever courses she studied. I generally look at the old courses view, it's more informative. When the internet was down. And if you log back on today, maybe it will upload it. Because the records that you want, if it's showing in the records in there, that means it hasn't yet been synchronized. And what happens is, if you have an offline system, it's stored on the server in this case. This means that if before it took 10 questions to get to 80% completion, if I dropped it to 50% as an example, making your math easier, I know you're mathematically challenged now. If it were 50%, how many sentences would you have to hear to get to 80%? Completion number rises faster. And something else happens. This number here. This is called the shuffler level. And as you can see, the first time she got 0.0. That's no particular reason. That's just the highest that we go. We go from 0 to 3. At 3.0, all the most difficult versions of the sentences will be available. You remember the shuffler. Certain sentences become revealed the second, third time as you go through. But that's all dependent on answering questions correctly and your shuffler level going up. If you missed questions, it would stay the same. You wouldn't get used. You'll get easy sentences and hard sentences mixed up. But as your shuffler level goes up, you also get a multiplier effect, meaning that one sentence has more value than one point. If your shuffler level is high, you get more faster completion. If your shuffler level is low, you get less fast completion. So, you don't really understand? You do. All of you do. You sure?
If it's
same time still got they will actually reach the division faster. Even the recommended setting time will reduce the overall time for everybody. But the shuffler will reduce the time even more for the better students. Okay, thank you. Sit down. This is almost what all native speakers do. If they're holding a microphone, they go blah, 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 the end. Because they've already finished the sentence in their head. They drop the microphone before the end of the sentence. If you're wearing a microphone on the headphone, it's better. Because you can't move away from it. But these are all little things that you notice. If there's noise, it's going to be less